I stumbled upon this video at random. I was just like searching some random shit, but then I found something that sort of kind of fucking gave me a bit of a hard on. I don't think that's the right word to say. My curiosity arose when I saw this video, and the video is called Verona Sucks, Here's Why. So this is the guy that made the video. Make sure you guys go sub and whatever you just want to.
What's going on, guys? It's your boy that makes videos that may or may not piss you off, and today we're going to be talking about For Honor.
The guy that pisses you off, bro. I piss people on the daily. Literally. I pissed off half the community. Half the front of community, I pissed the fuck off. I'm not even kidding you. Pissed them all off because of a tier list. And it was a joke one too, so that makes it even funnier.
For Honor is a pretty broken and shattered game. It has fallen into a place where it has become increasingly more aggravating to play. Also, the atmosphere of this game is pretty toxic, and we are going to talk about why. I'm going to break this video down into four parts: the meta, the toxic player base, the matchmaking, and the mechanics.
Verona's been toxic for like the longest fucking time. All games are toxic in their own little way. I mean, I'm kind of interested to see what he says about the whole, all four of them. Actually, really interested, especially the mechanics. I'm really interested in to see what he says about the mechanics. Probably like fucking Orochi and how his fucking aids.
The meta in For Honor heavily shifted recently with the big nerf to Raider and the introduction of Jormungandr. Also, I'm not exactly sure how to pronounce Jormungandr's name. Is it Jormungandr, Jormungandir? I don't really know, so I'm just gonna call her Yorm.
He got it right the first time. It's not Jormungandr, Jormungandr. I say Gander because I can. But what do you have to say about Jormungandr? That's the thing, because a lot of people, and I'm talking about like 95% of the community don't like Jormungandr. A lot of the community also say that Jormungandr is really easy character to verse and all that. It's like, yeah, you're triggering me. Please explain.
Yorm is unhealthy for the game in a few ways. At her core, she is a stamina bully, which is a weird character style to place in a game where we completely rely on stamina to do anything. So fighting Yorm is like fighting someone that doesn't want you to be able to play the game.
That's basically it. Jormungandr is a fucking bully. Okay, imagine you're getting bullied and someone's like just punching the shit out of you. That's Jormungandr. You're actually a really nice guy, like myself. I like to say that I'm actually a really nice guy. Jormungandr is an asshole. Straight up asshole.
Having less stamina reduces how much you can retaliate and combo against a character, which can make fighting Yorm pretty annoying. And of course, let's not forget how heavily Yorm capitalizes on knocking a player out of stam, which is a pretty easy task for her to do. Also, going for a parry on Yorm is almost suicide if the player knows how to feint and guard break. She can also take two bars of health in one hammer slam and get an overshield for landing that hammer slam. Yeah. I think that's a bit ridiculous. Not to mention, every move Yorm does is pretty much a 50-50. And if you guess wrong.
Whoever decided to make character Jormungandr, whoever decided that, deserves to be fired immediately. And don't even get me started on the people that think that Jormungandr is fucking easy to verse. In reality, Jormungandr isn't easy at all by any means. Like, so many people underestimate Jormungandr. And then they cry when they get fucking beaten. It's like, well, you said that Jormungandr wasn't easy. There you go. Dumbass. That's Jormungandr. He's gonna predict what he's gonna fucking do. Grab you, punch you, throw a light, throw another light, a follow-up light, heavy you. Not to mention, he's got high prime his first fucking attack, so that's fun.
And although Yorm is probably my biggest problem with this game in terms of a hero, she is only a small part of the problem.
No, wait, no, hit a kid. No, Jormungandr is a big problem. He's just annoying as fuck.
Now, of course, every hero can be really strong in their own way, but some heroes can do that way easier than others with way less effort. Now, I'm not saying that every player that plays these heroes is inherently bad at the game, because there are definitely some good players out there that play these heroes, but they have created a certain kind of meta that isn't necessarily fun for anyone who isn't playing those characters.
That's the truest thing I've ever fucking heard in my life. The biggest example is Orochi. I've seen some amazing Orochi players who don't like spam. They actually parry you, they fucking deflect you, and they're just beast. But then there's the 98% of Orochis in the entire world who decide, hey, I'm getting shit on, I'm gonna light spam and just be hated by everyone in the community.
Now put a player like me against someone who plays nothing but Lawbringer or Yorm or any other strong hero for that matter, and knows every mix-up in the book, and knows the exact last second they can feint their attacks to trip you up. Can you guess who would probably win that fight? Of course it's going to be the guy who plays the same hero all the time.
That I have to disagree with, because I have beaten players who do nothing but light spam and dodge on attacks and will literally turtle their fucking ass off. If you kind of dwindle on them and kind of just be patient, you can win most of your fights, and also it does depend on who you're versing. So people can sit there and say like, oh, Lawbringer's S tier. Warden is S tier. Hidakiri is fucking S tier. BP's high A. It's true that they are, but it kind of depends on who the player you're versing is. I have been beaten by a rep 1 Lawbringers. I've been beaten by a rep 70 Lawbringers. It doesn't matter. It's how people play the character, and it's who you're playing.
And for most heroes, there is a flaw that you can exploit. For example, Orochi's dodge attacks are easily parried and can be baited out most of the time. Heroes like Lawbringer don't have a huge weakness, so it's inherently more difficult to counter them.
Just to clarify before we get into the next bit, this video was made 3 months ago. But no, I agree. There are characters out there that just do stuff better. So Conqueror does stuff better than BP. I think Conqueror is better than BP, in my personal opinion. I do agree that Lawbringer, don't get me wrong, Lawbringer is hard to beat. Even like someone who is actually new to the game, Lawbringers can be hard to beat, which is why I always stand by with what I say. And that is, you can name any character S tier, D tier, B tier, B tier, whatever it is. It really comes down to the person you're fighting, the player, the online player. That's it. I've been beaten by Shinobis before, and he is fucking garbage of a character. But I've been beaten by him because I've just been outsmarted, outparried, out everything. You know what I mean?
Putting on all of this as if it's a big deal. Well, because it is. It changes the way people play and treat the game. When there are extremely powerful meta heroes present that don't have a big exploitable weakness, it forces most people into a pigeonhole. Most people are playing nothing but the top tier characters because that's all they can find success with.
This is also true, especially in duels. A lot of the time, when I'm searching duels, and I live in Australia, so duels is like fucking dead, I'm usually getting matched with players who are like low levels, but they... So yeah, I do agree with that people use these characters because it's an easy win. It's like, why do I need to use Centurion when I can use fucking Warden or Lawbringer? When I'm playing duels a lot of the time, I run into a lot of S tier characters and low levels. Now, these low level players that I'm versing, they're usually good because they're using S tier characters.
No one wants to lose. I've even seen it with my own friends. They try to play heroes like Shinobi or Orochi and then immediately go back to their main after losing to a Lawbringer 8 times in a row. I've asked myself that question a million times. Why not just main a meta hero? And I think the answer for me is, I can't play the same character over and over again because I find that boring. I don't want to feel like I'm playing Kensei or Warden Simulator. I want to feel like I'm playing For Honor, which to me is playing every hero the game has to offer.
I know a friend of mine who has rep 10 on every character in the game. I think he's got like one character, maybe one, I'm not entirely sure. He will probably put in the comments below, maybe, I don't fucking know. But I think he's got like one character who's not rep 10 yet, or he might have every character rep 10, I don't know. But he can't play the same character consistently. He has to play a different character, and that's how For Honor should be. So I'm not going to go through the whole entire thing. I'm just going to like say the points that he makes and all that kind of stuff. But if you guys want to watch the whole thing for yourselves, a link and his channel going to be in the description below if you want to watch the whole thing. Like I said, I'm just going to try and get the main points out and express my own opinions. But if you guys want to watch the whole thing, down below in the description.
The next topic is the toxic player base, and this goes hand in hand with the meta. Players in For Honor are abnormally toxic slash mad. There's a lot of hate mail, lots of chat spamming, and lots of toxic play. And by toxic play, I mean exploiting environmental kill zones over and over again, or doing nothing but ganking as a four-man team.
I mean, I don't see that as like fucking toxic, ganking in four, man. I don't see that as toxic. Ledging, I can see that being annoying as fuck, but Forerunner have literally barricaded, like, most of the maps. But even I do, I ledge people in Dom. Like, I don't give a fuck. You put yourself in that position, you're gonna get ledged. If I get ledged, then I put myself in that position, I deserve it. So it is.
Losing 7 times in a row to people you know you could beat if they weren't playing that stupid hero is an awful feeling. And that fills up that rage meter pretty quickly. And
have you guys ever been in a situation like that? Have you guys ever versed someone who is easy as fuck, but he just uses a character that and he just exploits with, but you know that he's really shit, but he's just using exploits to win, but he's actually really bad, and you've lost? Have you guys ever been in a situation like that? Because I have.
And oh god, the matchmaking. Don't even get me started. For Honor's matchmaking is awful. Hands down, one of the worst I've ever experienced.
Yeah, the matchmaking of For Honor is fucking atrocious. It's terrible. It's so bad. Like, I play on PC sometimes. I'm rep 4-5 on PC, right? I got matched with a rep 200. So matchmaking in For Honor is kind of bad. It's really bad.
Last but definitely not least is the mechanics. For Honor's mechanics definitely need some fixing. Fundamentally, they are fine, but they need some tweaks here and there. First of all, revenge is a broken mechanic. Either it works too well, or it doesn't work at all. I find myself asking the question, where's my revenge, quite often.
Yep. Revenge is fucking terrible. I can literally, like, light someone, and he has revenge. I can kick someone in the stomach with Centurion, they have revenge. I could breathe on someone and have revenge. I can literally be standing there and I have revenge. When I'm getting ganked by 3 people, I never get revenge. Never. But I can 1v1 someone and he gets revenge in like 2 fucking attacks. It is so fucking broken. It's unbelievably retarded. Revenge in this game is the worst. Oh, it's terrible. It's terrible as shit. It's worse than my fucking T list that I made.
Second on the list is the guard mechanics, especially reflex guard. I've talked with quite a few people about this to confirm my suspicions, and they are all experiencing the same thing I am. Blocking will just flat out not work sometimes. I don't know if it's a latency related issue or not, but either way, it's awful. For example, I'll be sitting in, let's say, right guard. An attack will come from the same side, and it will just hit me as if I wasn't even blocking.
This does still happen, though. I think it does. I think it has something to do with the latency or something like that. I don't really know about this one, to be honest. This one's a bit weird, because there have been some times where a clear heavy is coming my way, but I missed the parry. I know I'm just really fucking terrible. A raider will just throw a heavy. It's like, oh, easy fucking parry. He's fucked. He's dead. No, I'm dead. I don't know what it is. It's just, it must be like a latency issue, but I don't really know about the whole reflex guard thing. That thing confuses the fuck. I mean, you know, this game confuses the shit out of me sometimes. So there's some things that I do agree on, some things that I don't, but one thing that I do want to talk about, and I did say this before, was, like I said, you can put Lawbringer, BP, all that in S tier, and all that kind of stuff, but it really comes down to who you're versing. Like, I've beaten somewhat really high level Lawbringers, some high level Warlords, some high level BPs, and I've beaten them with the worst character in the game, that being Centurion. I think he's top 3 or some shit like that. So S tier, B, C tier, doesn't matter. It really comes down to the player. Obviously, if you play an S tier character, it's going to be easier for you, but it kind of depends on how that player is playing Lawbringer or BP or whoever. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Make sure you hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and as I said, this video will be down below. If you guys want to watch the whole thing for your guys selves, go watch it. There's some things that I didn't cover because this video would be like really long, and I don't really want it to be 20 minutes long. So there's some things that I didn't cover in this video. There's the main points that I covered. So yeah, hope you guys enjoy it anyway, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Keep your head held high, and I'll talk to you later. Peace out, guys.